But we have with us, and when we invited Evangelist Gene Martin, he was in meeting. He was in meeting, and I don't mean preaching to two or three folks. And he canceled them out, closed out, and made his way up here, not just for Sunday, but he's been here for the last couple of days or so, and enjoying the meeting. And we're certainly grateful. He goes way back to the A.A. Allen time. Oh! And he has been singing and preaching, and it's a joy to have him. It's a joy to have him. And we're on his time now. We're 45 minutes on his time. And we're going to ask everyone, let's bring him in for the first time here at Monument. But we sure won't be the last time. Let's bring him in, Monument, with a heart of deliverance. And because God is doing a new thing, and then here's the part we love about it, God is doing a new thing. Are a part of it. Let us say thank you, Lord.
I don't have much time because I don't want to interfere with the night service, but in the year 1800, a baby was born by the name of Fanny Jane Crosby. At the age of 6 weeks, Fanny Jane Crosby became ill. They rushed her to the hospital. The doctor gave her some medicine to cause the little girl to go blind. At the age of 6 weeks, they carried her back to the specialist. The specialist said, poor little blind girl, no help, no hope. At the age of 8 years old, Fanny Jane Crosby was inspired to become a great writer. Picked up a pen and wrote, oh, what a happy child I am. Although I'm blind, contented in this world I'll be. A few years later, in her 60s, she was riding on the stagecoach and it turned over. She was on her way to a concert in the stagecoach turned over, and she was laying there in the sand waiting for someone to help her, and she was inspired to write one of our most popular songs that we yet sing today while she was laying there. Pass me not, O gentle Savior. Hear my humble cry. A few years later, after she had reached the age of 80, Jane Crosby to come and give her testimony how she has survived all these years. Fanny said, I don't want to say anything, but just let me sing my song. She said, blessed assurance, Jesus is mine. Oh, what a foretaste of glory divine. She said, I'm an heir of salvation. Purchased by my God. I've been born of his spirit. I am washed.
Go ahead.
I've been washed in blood. I'm talking about a woman that was blind and couldn't see. She said, perfect submission. Watch it. Looking, I'm looking above. So what's wrong with you? I've been blessed by his goodness. love. They said, you ought to have a sad story to tell. She said, I ain't through with my song yet. This is my story. Want to bother them, Pastor. But a man by the name of Edward Moat goes to the house of a woman that had accumulated all the riches, minks, furs, cars, houses. She lay on her deathbed. Edward Moat himself was a rich man. The Bible was not allowed in his house when he was a youngster. So when he got grown, he slipped away to every Bible and found out about Jesus and became a Christian. As Edward Moat watched this woman lay there and die and accumulated all the riches, and she couldn't carry them with her, he was inspired to go home and write, my hope is built on nothing less. Edwin Moat wrote that song. Than Jesus' blood and righteousness. He went on to say, on Christ, on Christ, on Christ. Shelf and grab some of the old songs. The younger generation won't know where they got the inheritance from. I ain't gonna bother you. Elisha A. Hoffman goes to the house to console a woman that had lost her son and her husband. Been a preacher, a songwriter. When he walked into the house, the woman said, What am I going to do, preacher? I lost my husband and my only child. What must I do? He said, all I can tell you to do is tell it to Jesus. He heard that woman said, I must tell Jesus. And after he prayed for her, he could hear these words ringing in his head, I must tell Jesus. Elisha A. Hoffman went home and picked up his pen and began to write, I must tell Jesus. Help me, Jesus. Joseph Scriven was in love with a woman, and she died one day before they was to get married. They found her over in a pool of water. They don't know if she drowned herself or was an accident or what. But after the funeral, Joseph Scriven was inspired to write, "What a friend we have in Jesus."
Way home.
jumping. I got in the choir, and I didn't want them to know I was getting it. I crossed my legs, folded my arms. We left there and went to the Second Corinth Baptist Church across town. Woo. And when I walked in, the Holy Ghost met me at the door. I started skipping and running. My Baptist pastor said, "Deacon, grab my boy and take him to the hospital. He's sick." But my old Baptist sanctified Holy Ghost to your mama said, "Turn my boy loose. God has just sanctified." Y'all don't hear me. On a Sunday night, I found myself back at that same altar hollering, "Glory, glory, glory." They said, "Say what I say." I tried, "G-g-g-g-g-g-g." I blew bubbles. They beat me in the back. They rubbed me down. They wiped spit. They said, "Get up and go home and come back tomorrow, you'll get it. God done purged you at the lips." But I haven't read nowhere in the Bible where you got to blow bubbles before the Holy Ghost come in. I went home and got on my Baptist knees and said, "Lord, thank you for saving a Baptist like me. Thank you for sanctifying a Baptist." When I came to myself, I was laying flat on my bed, on my back. Don't know how long I've been there. Don't know how I got there. But I was speaking in an unknown tongue. I came back to myself. She said, "He's got it." I stopped when I got a chance to get my English tongue. I said, "Mama, you ain't got to tell me I got it. I know for myself. I come tonight to tell you, don't let nobody tell you you ain't got it. You ought to know for yourself." I'm just giving you my story, that's all. I stayed in the Pentecostal church. Well, I'm going to tell you, I went back to the Pentecostal church on a Monday night, and I stood up to testify. I said, "I'm saved, sanctified, filled with the Holy Ghost." Somebody jumped up and said, "Sit down, brother, you didn't get it." I said, what you mean I didn't get it? "Because you didn't get it here last night." I said, "Well, one thing for sure, you ain't the giver of it. And I keep it until God tell you that I got it." And these 40 years, I've been saved, sanctified, and filled with the Holy Ghost. I'm 56 years old now. I know I don't look it because you don't see no gray hair. The beautician covered them up. I'm gonna look as young as I can while I can. I'll be old when I get old. Y'all don't wanna hear this. Been traveling for 36 years, day and night. I cannot say that I've always been perfect. I've been saved over 40 years and I failed more than 40 times. I don't rejoice because I failed, I rejoice because he picked me up again. That's the thing that keeps me going. I wrote a little song I heard on the radio when I was a kid in Atlanta. We didn't have no black gospel singers, so we had white country style singing, and my dad just turned the radio on every morning at 4 o'clock and say, "Turn the radio on,
turn your radio on,
and listen to the music
in the air.
Turn the radio on,
turn your radio on,
such a glorious share,
it's a glorious share.
Turn the lights down low,
turn your lights down low.
preacher, so I put his name in there. Richard Hinton will be preaching. Fred Pride will be teaching. Brother Shamba will be praying. Gene Martin will be singing. When we get through lifting up Jesus, you will have the victory. Get in touch with God. One more Tyrone. Let's see, still, I'm going to tell you this, I'm going to leave it alone. A man walked into the park of a great Christian picnic and they said, we don't want you here. We heard about your kind. You run women's, you get drunk. You're a dope addict. They said to Hank Williams Sr., we don't want your kind here. I know somebody invited you for the picnic, but we don't want your kind here. Hank Williams said, wait 1 minute, I'll be back. He ran out. Just hold your guitar up, son. He went out and got his guitar and came back and said, you heard what they said about me, that I was running women's and drunks. And he said, but you haven't heard my part yet. He said, I saw the lie. I saw the lie. No more in darkness. No more in night. Now I am happy. No sorrow inside. Pray the Lord.
I saw the lie.
See, I'm going to tell you something. I got to preach. I come from the old school when we didn't have no fancy Michael Jackson moonwalking dance. All we had was back and forth. Shatter or help, Lord is nigh. Somebody shout, get up! Get up, Jesus! Because the liars, the hypocrites, the backbiters, the homemongers is all raging. Oh, y'all don't want to have church. I'm gonna leave him alone. Bill Gaither wrote this song, and I changed it around along with Gloria Griffin, and we did it Afro-American style. The marketplaces are empty. There's no traffic in the street. The builders' twos are silent. There's no time to harvest wheat. Busy housewife cease to labor. There's no time for courtyard debate. Wake on earth has been suspended. And the king comes through the gate. Happy faces line the hallways of those whom life has been redeemed. Broken hearts which he have mended. From prison set free. Little children and the aged, hand in hand they stand aglow. Some are crippled, they are broken, they are wrong. Dressed in garments white as snow. Hear the chariot rumbling. I can see the marching band or the flurry of my God's trumpet. Of sin and shame. Jesus, 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 my King is coming. Aren't you glad? Aren't you glad the King is coming? Somebody ought to praise God. Coming back for me. Bill Gaither wrote that part. James Cleaner wrote this part. He's coming back again. Just like he said he would. J. to win. He's coming back. He's coming back for me. Listen, I wish. I know she's not here. But I wish Inez Andrew was here. She would say, Mary, oh, Mary, don't you came, you just said stood on the banks of the Jordan just to see the ship go. He didn't make it tonight either. James and Albertina Walker came. They just said, please be patient with me. God has got to be with me. Yes. Please. They didn't come. But I'm here tonight. Everybody cry, holy! See, I come from the old school where the saints used to say, why don't you let them in? Swallow water or something here. See, I'm from Georgia. And every now and then, my Baptists come out. See, and every now and then, somebody say, them old Baptists ain't got nothing. If they ain't got nothing, why you keep saying, Amen. Say praise. You didn't write it, the Baptist did. If they ain't got nothing, somebody say, well, maybe they got something but me, y'all. Methodists don't have nothing. If they ain't got nothing, why you keep singing, sweet I'm. Methodist did. You said them old white folks ain't got nothing. If they ain't got nothing, why you just keep saying, ah, fly away, oh glory. say, them Jesus only ain't got nothing. If they ain't got nothing, why you keep singing? Jesus. 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 J-E-S. You didn't write it, they did. You said them Church of God in Christ ain't got nothing. If they ain't got nothing, why you keep out of
Please receive Gene Martin.
I am so grateful that I've got Christ, and he's in my life. The devil said I would never sing again. I lost 20 pounds overnight. I dropped from 165 to 145 overnight. I had a cancer on the side of my face. The devil said I would never preach again. I had a heart attack. I could have been dead. Resting in my grave. Jesus spoke to death. He spoke to death. He said, death, 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 death. You better behave. I said, I'm grateful. I said, I'm grateful. I'm surely grateful. I've got Christ. I've got Christ, and he's The marketplaces are empty. There's no traffic in the street. The builder tools are silent. There's no time to harvest wheat. Busy housewife cease to labor. There's no time for courtyard debate. Work on earth has been suspended. And the king comes through the gate. Happy faces line the hallways of those whom life has been redeemed. Broken homes which he have mended. Those from prison set free. Little children and the aged, hand in hand, they stand aglow. Some are crippled, they are broken, they are ruined. Dressed in garments white as snow. Oh, I can see the marching crowd for the flurry of my God's trumpet. It's all in play. Heaven's choir have just assembled. Start to sing Amazing Grace.
Gene Martin, Tyrone Kinsey, and Praise and Victory, or Victory and Praise. Singers and shouters are going to sing for the Lord. Hello, Gene Martin.
Hello, Nancy. How you doing?
Welcome back to Love Special.
It's good to be back.
You like this place?
Oh, I like this place.
You're invited to come back anytime.
Thank you. I'll be back.
Tear it up.
Anybody here seen Mahalia Jackson? Oh, can you tell me? Oh, can you tell me? Can you tell me why she has gone? Last time I heard her singing, she was saying, "Praise the Lord, praise the Lord, take my hand." When I looked around, Mahalia Jackson was gone. Mm-hmm. Anybody here seen? Have you seen Ruth Davis? Oh, can you tell me? Oh, can you tell me? Can you tell me where she has gone? When I looked around, Ruth Davis was gone. Can you tell me? Oh, can you tell me? Can you tell me where he has gone? Meeting like this, turn your television program on and you ask, anybody here seen, have you seen Gene Martin, Tyrone, Jonathan, Cofield Twins, Anita Washington, can you tell me where Gene Martin has gone? Somebody gonna say the last time I heard him. Heard him singing a gospel song. Say he was on the love special singing one of these mornings. And it won't be very long. You're gonna look for me. Hear me praying.
farewell, darling.
And when he says, well done,
well done,
well done,
well done. Your rain,
your rain,
your rain,
your rain,
your rain,
your rain,
your rain.
We're
going to join hands together. Early telecast. I've been saved ever since I was 12 years old and been traveling on the road ever since 1960, 45 now, you know, getting on up there. But ever since I've been a Christian, I told the Lord this.
I want Jesus to walk with me. I want Jesus to walk.
Tomorrow, Looking back on yesterday, I don't want to hang my head in sorrow. Just because Jesus said I'm gone away, he'll be back someday. On his word I shall stand. Done before, he took away all my sins. Said, Gene, I wanna be your friend. He said, I'm going away, but I'll be back another day to receive you as my own. Ever done before. He took away all my sins. Said, Gene, I want to be your friend. Then he said, I'm going away, but I'll be back another day to receive you. That you live. I'm going there because he looked beyond all of my faults and saw. He saw my need.
Keep holding on,
holding on,
holding on
through my trials. Nancy and I used to sing together a long time ago, and she asked me to do a little verse of this, and it's one of them, hand clapping, feet stomping songs, you know. And some people don't like all this, but you know, they always talk about, you know, we're too loud because we shout and praise the Lord, but they don't ever say anything about the football game and basketball game, you know, and all that kind of stuff, you know. So I just like to have church. You know, and get your feet to stomp, because we're going to have church over here tonight. And hallelujah. I know we only got about 5 more minutes, but we might as well have church. You know what I'm trying to say? How many believe in having church? How many believe in clapping your hands?
Oh,